Hello all, I am Veeru from electronicsinnovation.com. I am your host for this episode. Welcome to the second part of the tutorial on how to make single channel gateway with Wemos D1 Mini Pro and RFM95 module. In the previous tutorial, we have seen how to make hardware for the single channel gateway. Then we had programmed it. Then the gateway created an access point for us. Now we will connect to that access point and configure the gateway to talk with the Things Network server. And then we will register the gateway on the Things Network server itself. Finally, we will test the gateway. Before jumping into the configuration part, I would like to take a moment and thank PCBs.com for sponsoring this project by sending these external PCBs for RFM95 module. This RFM95 module is not breadboard friendly. So I have designed an external PCB and ordered it on PCBs.com. PCBs.com is an online PCB manufacturing enterprise which provides all services you need to make hardware for your IoT or embedded devices. If you have a similar requirement, do check out their website for more details. The link is in the description below. Connect to the access point created by the gateway by entering the default password 128. Once the connection is successful, open your favorite browser and hit the following IP 128.168.4.1. Then the following administration page will appear. Input the universal administration credentials, that is username admin and password admin. Then log into it. Now we need to make this gateway to connect to the available Wi-Fi network. These are the available Wi-Fi networks in the device range. Select one network. In my case, it is electronicsinnovation.com and then enter the password. Scroll down and click on Save Settings. Wait for few seconds and you will see the status changed to connected from disconnected, and you can also see the signal strength of the available network. Now we can access the same gateway configuration portal by connecting to the same network our gateway connected to. For that, get the IP of the gateway from the router administration panel. As you can see here, our gateway is allocated with 192.168.1.31 IP. Copy this particular IP. So now open the new tab and hit with the same IP we have copied earlier. You can see the same portal appeared. Close the previous session and just log into the gateway configuration portal by entering the universal username and password, that is admin. The Wi-Fi client configuration part is done. Coming to the access point, you can also change the credentials or SSID and password of the access point here. But for me, it's okay to keep the default credentials, so I'm not changing them for now. Coming to the WAN section, here we have the gateway ID. We will use this gateway ID to register on the Things Network server. So quickly open the Things Network server, log into the console, and then select the right cluster, and then open the ThingStack platform. Then go to the gateway section. Now click on Add Gateway. This is the gateway registration page. The owner will be selective by default. If you want, you can change it. Enter gateway ID. This can be an alphanumeric string, but only lowercase alphabets are allowed. Then enter the gateway EUI. This can be found on the gateway WAN page. Copy that and paste it here. Then give a name for your gateway. This can be anything. Uppercase alphabets are also allowed here. If you want, we can also add a description for the gateway as shown here. Then just remember the gateway server address. It is an important address. Keep all these selections default. Select the right frequency plan. I am from India, so 865 to 867 is selected. Then click on Create Gateway. That's it. The gateway has been created successfully. And the status of the gateway showing disconnected for now because a couple of configurations are pending. Let's do them now. Now go to the gateway configuration page and expand the configuration section, and then make sure the host or server's address is EU1.1.1.1. cloud.things.network. I have asked you to remember the server address, right? The same address should be selected here. Keep the rest of the settings default as shown here. Then click on Save Settings. Then coming to the RFM section, we need to provide a frequency channel in which we would like to make this gateway to communicate with the end nodes. So, to know the frequency channels for the desired country or frequency band, visit the following page. The link is provided in the description below for this page. Here you can find the channels for your country. So, I am from India and there are 3 frequency channels for uplink and 4 frequency channels for downlink. So, the frequency channel for my single channel gateway could be 865.0625 MHz. So, I copied it and pasted it on the gateway configuration page. Then expand the configuration section and make sure you have entered the minimum and maximum frequencies of the frequencies band. And keep the rest of the settings default or as shown here, follow these settings. Then click on Save Settings. In the system section, we don't have to do anything. Keep all the settings default. That's it. Now come back to the Things Network server. As you can see here, the last seen of the gateway is few seconds ago, which means our gateway successfully connected to the Things Network server and it is communicating seamlessly. The live data log also showing that it has received the gateway status matrix. So with this information, we can say that our single channel gateway successfully connected and communicating with the Things Network server. Now let's test this gateway, whether it will receive the LoRaWAN data packets from the LoRaWAN devices and forward them to the network server. Go to the application. As you can see here, we have some devices already registered and communicated with the Things Network server. So for testing purposes, I will activate one of the devices and see whether the gateway will receive the data and forward it to the Things Network server. So before that, I would like to confirm that the other gateway is turned off and the current status of the gateway is disconnected. So if any data packet is received by the network server, that should be come from the newly developed single channel gateway only. So I have activated one LoRa END node and you can see that the last seen of the device is few seconds ago. We have also received few data packets from the device. We keep on receiving these data packets seamlessly. If I open the data packet, we can see that this is the raw encrypted data we have received and the decoded payload here. We can also see the gateway ID and the gateway UI from here. So, with all the proofs, we can proudly say that our single channel gateway is doing its duty perfectly and working seamlessly without any errors. So, that's it for this tutorial. We have successfully made a single channel gateway with Wemos D1 Mini Pro and RFM95 module and configure it to communicate with the Things Network server. Also tested with the LoRaWAN devices we have developed in the earlier tutorials. Stay tuned to Electronics Innovation for more interesting videos on LoRaWAN. See you soon. Bye-bye.